In 2006, I knew that I wanted to open my own brew pub, and I knew that I wanted to do it in DC. You know, the neighborhood culture of DC is, it's a lot like a small southern town, and my father-in-law has, on more than one occasion, said, this is right proper beer. So that's where the name came from. My name is Thor Cheston. I'm the owner of Right Proper Brewing Company here in Washington, D.C. I wanted our connection to D.C. to be the other D.C., the neighborhood, the residents. The population of D.C. is getting younger. They're educated. They are gainfully employed. They have disposable income. And they're starting to demand higher quality and not taking the word of marketers that are marketing their products on television. I wanted a brewer that really was in touch with yeast and cultivation of yeast and caring for it and realized that its importance. And that's why I tapped Nathan.
My name is Nathan Zeender, the head brewer here at Right Proper Brewing Company in Washington, D.C. The idea here is we're a small sort of a hands-on brew pub, right? It's a very small system here. We only brew about 150 gallons every time we brew. We usually have about six of our own beers on tap, and then we have usually two lines dedicated to guest beers, and that's usually breweries, local breweries that we have good friendships with. Since the beers here only last 1 or 2 weeks on tap, it's like, let's drink through it, and then we can try the next experimental hop variety. Where my sort of inspiration, where I'm coming from when I'm trying to brew, is I'm going for relatively balanced and drinkable beers, you know, with sort of maybe a creative overlay on top of it, you know? But generally, I don't like beers gonna push any one flavor profile too much, like the bitterest beer, the strongest beer you can brew or something like that. And so I try to have a sort of a culinary mindset, you know? And so look at it and say, I wouldn't want to brew the saltiest dish that's ever been made, or, you know, it doesn't make any sense, you know? So I try to think about sort of balanced flavors. And so that's sort of, you know, I just think about it as another form of sort of cooking, really, you know? So I think that's a lot of where my mindset is when it comes to brewing.
We knew that there was a lot of excitement building up for Right Proper, and that we were going to be busy and we were going to sell a lot of beer. We didn't know that we were going to be completely inundated and actually sell out of beer on a regular basis. But it's going to be a long time before DC and the neighborhoods of DC are saturated. The market is saturated with restaurants, bars, and craft beer. I would like to set up a small production facility as well, where we can focus on larger batches of our more popular beers that we could sell within the DC market to other restaurants and bars and things like that. And then leave our small brew house here as really kind of an experimental, you know, fun, playful brewery where Nathan can just go crazy with stuff.
I try to put a little bit of thought into the naming of the beer. Sometimes they come like that, and sometimes they take a little bit of brooding to get to, you know? But generally, I keep them relatively like playful, a lot of play on words, things like that. And but it is fun. It makes my job a little more creative, you know, to try to sometimes outdo myself. And, you know, we put all this time into making the beer. We put a little bit of effort into naming the beer, too, so.
I'm less concerned about being a package brewery that's going to be shipping to other states. I'd like to just, you know, firm up our roots here in DC.